After the huge success of season one, the Challenge All-Stars are back for another round with even more fan favorites and even more jaw-dropping challenges that will put even the most seasoned veterans to the test. Take a look.
Some of you have been waiting a long time for this, the chance to capture that elusive victory. To earn your second chance, you gotta work harder and dig deeper. Welcome to the all-new second season of the Challenge All-Stars.
And executive producer and MTV legend Mark Long joins me now. Hey, Mark.
Hi.
Well, it is great to see you. And it's time to talk about the Challenge All-Stars season two. How soon after season one were you like, oh yeah, we're going to do a season two?
So I knew it was going to be a success even when the trailer dropped, because even with the little 15-minute trailer for season one, we got 5.1 million views in like a week.
I mean, there was this article that came out that said, this is a masterclass in exactly what this show should be. How does something like that make you feel?
I think what everyone loves about All Stars is we really brought it back to the simpler days. It's the faces that you know, that you grew up with.
And you have 24 cast members returning this season, and some that haven't competed in like 20 years. What do you have? Brad, Tina, Ayana. Who are you most excited to see come back?
I think it's going to be a great blend of season one faces with season two. And look, again, there's going to be a lot of money on the line. So things might get squirrely as the days and competitions move on.
So let's talk about the actual challenges. They are no joke. You said that earlier. How do you come up with them? What makes a good challenge?
I think what makes a good challenge, first of all, when you have men and women competing and you want to make everything fair, I think what makes a good challenge is playing it so that a woman or a man can play it equally. And the fear, listen, when you raise someone on top of a 150-story building, whether you're man, female, baby, dog, I mean, everyone fears heights. If they don't, they're lying.
So you're actually an EP this season and you're not competing. Was that a difficult decision to make?
No, it isn't. And because I'm EP and I kind of started the wave of it, I really, to be honest with you, I don't get any spoilers. I don't get any competitive advantages, even when I'm not competing. So I didn't know the format. I love the fact that I'm getting the credit for bringing the nostalgic feel and the theme back. But just know that I'm the last to know anything when it comes to games or cast or casting people. Like, they keep me out of the loop.
You posted this summer that Road Rules is not dead. Now, with the success of All Stars, are we going to be bringing Road Rules back? Are you bringing Road Rules back?
All Stars and like the Real World Reunion, they're so popular that I think the bandwidth of just bringing it back at this very moment is limited. I think it's definitely on the table. I moved back from LA to Orlando 2 years ago. And I said to my dad the other day, who would have thought it would take me moving back to Florida, starting a regular job, and then having the best year of my life in Hollywood? Who would have thought that was the path to go through? So, you know, I'm now left my job. I just started my own production company. So I'm going to be doing projects even outside of this as well. So I'm looking forward to that. All reality. And little sneak peek. During season two, I actually shot another show. That'll be coming out on another network that is totally fish out of water for me. And you are going to die laughing because it's, again, they took a lot of TV nostalgic 90s people, a lot of sitcom people. I was the token reality star of the 90s. So it's a damn good year for Mark Long and Mark Long Productions.
And you can catch the Challenge All-Stars streaming now on Paramount+.